Welcome, friends, family, and distinguished guests. You may all be seated. Today, we continue our celebration of the class of 2020. The class is so amazing that you're having two graduations. We know that there's a lot of pain and hurt in the world right now. As one historian has said, our country is experiencing the Spanish flu of 1918, the Great Depression of the 1930s, and the Civil Rights Movement of the 1960s, all at the same time. As these events unfold, we cannot give up hope. Not only are we resilient, but as Dr. Martin Luther King said, the arc of the moral universe is long, but it bends towards justice. So in a time of so much pain, we hope that the next 90 minutes will bring you a sense of optimism, bring you a sense of joy, and bring you a sense of love. You are going to hear words of inspiration and affection from people you know and love, people who know that you, the class of 2020, you have faced challenges, but the best of you is still unwritten. Class of 2020, your commencement speakers.
Hello, class of 2020, and congratulations. You've made it, and you did it during an unprecedented time of challenge. You should take pride in knowing that your hard work, dedication, talent, and skill have served you well and will continue to do so as you move into the next chapter of your life. If there's one thing that pandemics have shown us, it's that life doesn't always go according to plan, and it's full of surprises. Just a couple of months ago, you were dreaming about standing with your classmates shoulder to shoulder, dressed in your cap and gown, and clutching your high school diploma. You were dreaming of a milestone moment, a pivot from high school to your future as an adult and to college, work, or a gap year. That would be your oyster. But this crisis has changed the world as we all know it. Your school closed and you switched to distance learning. You couldn't see your teachers and classmates in person. You spoke to them via Zoom. You depended on technology to connect to the world, and often the connection feels lonely. You missed your friends, you missed your freedom to run around, you missed everything we used to consider as normal. I know this is hard. It is hard for all of us, but we can't allow ourselves to give up. We have to recognize the silver linings and remember the lessons we've learned in order to emerge stronger, wiser, and hopefully kinder. Look at your family. We spend more time together, taking walks in our neighborhoods, cooking and sharing meals, exchanging ideas and reflections, reaching out to family and friends we haven't spoken to in a while, reading books, slowing down the frantic pace of pre-pandemic life. Look at your community. We help our neighbors by shopping for them or bringing them meals. We order out to support our local restaurants. We clap in our front yards and put stuffed animals and hearts in our windows to say thank you to our healthcare and other frontline workers. We wear masks to protect others from catching the virus. Look at the earth. As we are forced to stay at home, drive less, and shutter our factories, our air has become cleaner, our oceans and beaches less polluted. Wildlife emerges to fill the void humans are leaving behind. We can hear the chirping of birds that used to be drowned out by traffic and airplane noise. It's up to us what we learn from this crisis and how we shape our future. You are the future and will be in the driver's seat. You are the ones making choices as you move into adulthood. I used to think that each of us gets his or her fair share of challenges in life, but that's not how it works. You're looking at a three-time loser, I lost for student body president in high school. I lost when I ran for Congress first time some 41 years ago. And I lost when I ran for lieutenant governor in 2006. But each loss made me stronger and set me up for a success. Without those losses, my life would have taken on a very different path. But I deeply believe that there is a plan for each of us. We just don't know what the plan is and are tested along the way. When I graduated from high school, I applied to Stanford and UC Davis. Stanford rejected me, which I will never forgive them for, and I went to UC Davis instead. As it turned out, UC Davis was very close to the Capitol in Sacramento, and that's how I launched my career in politics. I interned for my mentor, the late Congressman Leo Ryan. A few years later, after I had earned my law degree from UC Hastings in San Francisco, I came back to Congressman Ryan and worked for him as a legislative aide in Washington, D.C. Some of you may know that I joined him on that trip to Guyana, where we were trying to figure out whether his constituents were held against their will by a cult leader, Jim Jones, of the People's Temple. What unfolded was one of the largest mass murders in history, known as Jonestown. Leo Ryan was assassinated, and I was shot 5 times and left for dead on that airstrip. After months of recovery, I ran for Congressman Ryan's district seat, and I lost. But I had won. I would never have run for the San Mateo Board of Supervisors the following year, where I then served for 6 years. I then went on to get elected first to the California State Assembly and then to the State Senate, serving in the state legislature for 18 years. And then I got elected to the U.S. House of Representatives. During my time in the state legislature, I was pregnant with our second child. And one day on my drive to Sacramento, I received a call. My husband was killed in a car accident. That was the toughest time in my life. I was being tested yet again, and I survived. I raised 2 beautiful children as a single mom for 8 years before remarrying. And what helped me survive those challenges are what I call the 3 F's: family, friends, and faith. Now you are facing your challenge of a lifetime. You have it within you to not only survive, but to make the world a better place. The world is still your oyster. Your graduation may look different than you expected, but embrace the surprises that come your way and turn them into opportunities. And please, don't be afraid to fail. You know, I keep a paperweight on my desk in Washington that reads, "What would you do if you knew you could not fail?" Let me assure you, failure isn't the end. It's actually the beginning to all the greatest success stories. It's how you work to achieve your dreams and also realize new dreams. So, congratulations again to the class of 2020 on your remarkable achievement in the face of a historic crisis. I know you have a bright future ahead of you, and you will go on to do even greater things. Bless you all.
Hello, and congratulations. We are so proud of you. You are DTech. You are going out into the world representing success and empathy and joy and working together and collaboration. And once again, I wish you so much luck. And all of us at Oracle will be thinking about you and hoping that you enjoy the next step in your career. Congratulations, have fun, and come on back to us. Bye.
Hey, class of 2020. I wish we could all be together, but I'm so proud of you. You are graduating at a defining moment for our global society and the planet. One in which we are living the consequences of how humanity has chosen to inhabit Earth use resources, and build systems. We need to do better. And no one is more prepared to do that than you are. With your empathy, your design and innovation skills, your understanding of the power of community, no one is more ready to set the world on a better path than you are. With your knowledge that failure isn't a destination, but a learning opportunity. And with your clear-eyed, practical, and relentless optimism, you can build solutions and make good choices. Don't forget what's bad about this moment, but don't let it define you either. Use it as fuel. Be brave. Be happy and healthy. Be good citizens and vote. Be confident in your creativity and in the power of working together. And go design a better future.
Hello to the Design Tech class of 2020. I want to thank you all for the years of fun, the collective ups and downs, and for making high school a wonderful, unforgettable experience. Going into freshman year, I knew I was forgoing a normal high school experience. What I didn't know is just how much I was going to love the experiences I ended up having. And that's thanks to all of you. In freshman year, we walked into orientation, we looked around at all the excited teachers, and wondered what we had just gotten ourselves into. In sophomore year, we watched an epic dance battle between Freedom and Miss Sigmund and moved into our new campus. Junior year was basically just a lot of SAT prep and seniors telling us it would get better. And senior year, waking up unnaturally early to watch the fog get slowly brighter on our senior sunrise. Our time has gone by way too fast. We have faced the situation we are in now so well. We have banded together when we needed to. This is a continuation of our grade, stepping up to any challenge, no matter how daunting. I want you all to think about this. Throughout trials and tribulations, we have been united, maybe not around one idea or ideology, but we have a camaraderie that extends past the ideological divides that are so prevalent in our modern era, and we have been able to come together when it matters, linking arms, hanging our heads, and observing that 17 minutes of silence, speaking up when we think something is wrong, and having the hard conversations throughout our 4 years. We have stood up in our own ways against what we think is wrong or what we need or what we know needs to be talked about. Most of us are adults now. We have formalized power in our society. We can vote. We can take a simple action to make a difference. I want to ask all of you to not stand idly by while others make decisions. 18 to 24-year-olds have the lowest voting percentage of any group. While we are the ones who are going to have to solve the problems of tomorrow and be faced with the problems created today. Class of 2020, make your voices heard. In our time here, we have proudly said that we are the Design Tech class of 2020. We have stood up for one another and stood up to what we think is wrong and have made our voices heard. We are defined not by what we have gone through, but how we have faced it, and how we will continue to thrive in whatever environment we are in, and how we will continue to grow to the size of the pond we are about to be thrown into. Thank you all. I know each and every one of you will fulfill the mission we were given on our first day of orientation, because I believe the world can be a better place, and we, yes we, can be the ones to make it happen. Thank you.
Hello to family, friends, faculty, and fellow graduates. It has been approximately 2 seconds since we stepped into the warehouse for the first time, and here we are. Although we can't be together in person, I feel so blessed to celebrate with all of you and to have spent 3.5 years learning alongside you. On behalf of the senior class, I'd like to thank all of the people who made graduating possible. Dr. Montgomery and Ms. Sarah for unwavering devotion to creating the school, the faculty and staff for teaching us so much, Oracle for their endless contributions to our adventures, including building our current campus, and our families, especially parents, for continued support as we embarked on unfamiliar journeys. Now I have good news and bad news, and I learned during senior year to always start with the bad news. So the bad news is we're starting a new unit. But before the senior class riots, here's the good news. This unit is a transition to the world of real life, and we will forever remember its lessons. Before we jump in, let's take a trip down memory lane with the plotline that we all know and love, and probably also hate, The Hero's Journey. For those of you who don't know, The Hero's Journey is a story template that involves a hero who goes on an adventure, triumphs over adversity, and returns home transformed. We thought we were done with it after freshman English, but it came back to haunt us as seniors too. The first stage in The Hero's Journey is the ordinary world, a horde of 13-year-olds in their bedrooms blasting One Dance by Drake. Then comes the call to adventure. In all those Hero's Journey tales, it's fate that brings the hero to their quest. It was also fate that brought all of us together. It was quite literally a lottery. And yet, at first some of us experienced the refusal of the call, as middle school friends continued on to a traditional high school. We didn't know what to expect, but 140 of us took the chance anyways. Over the last 4 years, I have had a lot of time to think about why. A lot of us were choosing between wherever most of our friends were going and DTEC, the school in a warehouse. I think there's one thing each of us knew all along, even if we didn't acknowledge it. Making history is a lot more fun than just learning it. A very wise teacher once said about us, "When you guys want to do a thing, you make the thing happen." From the class of 2020 came the travel program, TEDx, self-published yearbooks, an aquarium, our softball and baseball teams, the beautiful art installations on the Bay Trail, and many more. I don't think any of us could look at the last 4 years and say we didn't do something important and long-lasting. So, no matter how much we say we hate the hero's journey, it's pretty fitting for us. 140 different heroes creating their own stories, and most importantly, making history, whether we realize it or not. That being said, the hero's journey still involves tests. We battled Algebra 2, navigated the uncharted waters of competency-based learning, and mourned the loss of our beloved second lab day. We said tearful goodbyes to broken IKEA tables and whiteboard walls, random hanger applause, and the strong, headache-inducing smell of See's candies. With each step, we inched closer to the finish line, somehow getting used to living in a world that is always changing. Later, we approached the innermost cave, senior year. Throughout this past year, our ordeals involved the hefty decision of where to go next after our turbulent yet entertaining time here at DTEC, and the final boss battles, senioritis, and unexpectedly, the coronavirus. I'm proud to say that so far we have survived one of those. The journey that concludes for us today is just one of a large series, as we go on to face new adventures all throughout life. In our crazy, jam-packed world, the quests are ours to find. If DTEC has taught us one thing, it's that we are capable of finding and achieving them. And although at the end of these journeys we return to the ordinary world on separate roads, we return as anything but ordinary people. It looks like this is going to be an exciting unit, if I may say so myself. Thank you and congratulations to the class of 2020. I wish you all the best, and I can't wait to watch all of you continue to make history.
What's up? Class of 2020 is lighting up out here in the freaking ocean, dude. I'm doing my grad speech in the ocean. I'm so stoked. You know, it's a shame that we can't be all together right now, but we're making it work. We're still celebrating. Now I want to give a shout out to class of 2020, you know. Guys, we took the risk 4 years ago to come to DTEC, and now, look it, we're graduating. We all made it. So guys, all I want to say is we made it. Thank those teachers that helped you out. Give them a virtual hug. Buy them flowers. I don't know. Appreciate them though. So, you know, shout out to every single one of the staff members that helped us all out. Shout out to everybody making this whole virtual graduation happen. And you know what? Shout out class of 2020. Because you know what, guys? We may not all be together, but we're here in spirit, and we're all dragons at the end of the day. And you know what? Everybody, best of luck on your future, college, whatever you're doing. After that, who knows? We'll all be together. We'll all be reunited one day. At the end of the day, we're all from DTEC, and we're class of 2020. This isn't the way we want to be doing it, but we're out here, and we're in our own environment, and we're having a good time, and we're still graduating. So throw that cap off. Here's the 2020. Let's get it.
Hello, Design Tech High School class of 2020. It's Phil Lewis, Mr. Mosby from The Sweet Life of Zach and Cody and The Sweet Life on Deck. Congratulations on graduating high school. That is fantastic. And I know the Design Tech High School class of 2020 is going to go on and do great, great things. I understand the end of the year is not quite what you had expected, but we're going to get through this if we get through it together. And we're going to do it one day at a time. So think positively, and Design Tech High School class of 2020, I hope you have a wonderful summer, and I know that you are going to go on and do amazing things, and I cannot wait to see what those amazing things are. So enjoy your summer, and of course, Design Tech High School class of 2020, always remember, no running in my lobby.
This is for the Design Tech class of 2020. I'm Natasha Benningville, and I just want to sing a song for you guys. Feel the rain on your skin. No one else can feel it for you. Only you can let it in. No one else, no one else can speak the words on your lips. Judge yourself in words unspoken. Live your life with arms wide open. Today is where your book begins. The rest is still unwritten. Hey, I just want to say congratulations, DTech, Redwood Shores. You are the third ever graduating class of this new public charter school. Oh my gosh. This deserves celebration. What you have done is no small thing. And we are in an odd time right now where we can't even hug each other. But I just want to send you a virtual hug on the phone, and just to encourage you in the words of Unwritten to just know that this is your story, you're writing it, and it's exciting to see what the next chapters will be. You know, this is just that bit in the beginning of every fairy tale where there's some kind of mountain to climb over or some dragon to slay or something. We're all in that right now. We're all in that fight during this COVID time. But I just want to send you congratulations. This is something and a time for you to celebrate. Yes, thank you, and go Dragons.
Congratulations to the Design Tech High School class of 2020. This is wonderful. You've completed your course of study. You're going to go on to do many, many wonderful things. I know it's a difficult time for you right now with all this pandemic madness going on, but you're going to get through this and come through it with shining colors. Did I stutter? Your parents and your teachers support you, and they know that you're going to do great things out here in the world. Enjoy yourselves, enjoy your classmates, stay in contact with the people who make you smile and who inspire you to be creative and to go on to do greater things. Your design studies are going to help you no matter what course of study you take in advanced education or on any job you'll ever have. Design students have done everything from becoming plastic surgeons to designing clothes, aerospace engineers, interior design architects, fashion design, you name it. The world is yours. So claim your place in it and don't let anybody tell you what you can't do, because you can. Did I stutter? You can do whatever you set your mind to do. Go forth, do good things.
What's up, you guys? How are you? This is Melissa. I'm sitting here in my bathroom in a t-shirt and sweats giving a grad speech. I'm here to honor the class of 2020. Can life get any better than this? I don't think so. So here we go. I wanted to share a few words with you guys. So first and foremost, congratulations. This is huge. This is bigger than huge. This is your high school graduation, and I hope that you're proud of yourselves and that you're really enjoying this day and that you continue to enjoy it throughout the night, the weekend, the summer even. Why not? But for me, it feels like kind of yesterday that I met you. I remember you guys coming to Rollins for the first time, coming through the garage and hearing the crazy applause. You know, we'd always do these like applause lines with all the new students that came in. And I remember seeing you guys for the first time, this look of like terror and excitement on your face all in one as you started school in this wild auto body shop with cabinets and whiteboards separating classrooms. It was crazy. And I just remember thinking like those kids, they're very courageous people doing this. I don't know who they are, what they are, what they're doing, but that takes courage. And so, you know, that leads me to a quote that I absolutely love by Anais Nin. She said, life shrinks or expands according to one's courage. You have shown so much courage through our wild experiments and D-Lab explorations, your classrooms, literally your classroom space, moving mid-year, you know, doing all these like things that were just pioneering. They're paving the way for so many people that are going to continue your work for years to come at DTEC through empathy, compassion, all the things that we've tried to teach you over the years that you just warmly embraced and snickered a little bit, but we like that, you know, it kind of keeps it real. And I remember, you know, even more recently this year, in fact, I was, you know, I had this wild idea to teach at D-Lab that took you guys everywhere around the Bay Area. And I have such fond memories of the group that I was with. We, you know, we went everywhere and had a blast. We were in this weird, crazy van having great conversations. But one moment in particular really stood out to me that sort of highlights the relationship that you guys have with each other. And that's when we were at the Magical Bridge Playground and you were giving talks about what, like a Rollins memory. And people are sharing, you know, tears were flowing. You know, there was a vibe there that was really special. And, you know, we heard stories about talking to a girl for the first time and, you know, coming to their own as a person and, you know, all just everywhere in between. And I remember just looking around and being like, whoa, these kids are really like engaged in this moment right now, really listening to every single story and trying to absorb as much as they can and take it all in and just be there for that person. And I just thought that was really special all around. And I also have another kind of sort of combined memory with India and the Senior Fun Day. So a couple years back, we went to India. You guys know about that. India was a great experience. We hiked up to the Himalayas, sat there, meditated, just had this beautiful moment being there, right there in that moment, you know, after like a couple hours of a hike. And I never thought I would be able to find that moment again until this year happened when we did the Senior Fun Day. Shout out to Phoebe and Luis for that. And I just remember like standing back. I was walking around with Phoebe and I remember standing back and just watching you guys and, you know, taking that moment in and watching you guys take the moment in, like the human foosball table, the bouncy house, the music, the food, everything. It was just like we were present and it was special. And I hope that you remember that day as fondly as I do, because it was incredibly special. So, you know, I guess my advice to you in that is just be in the moment, you know, like take the time to appreciate when you have those special moments, because they come and go. And if you're just always going and not pressing pause, then you might miss out on those special moments. And so I want to leave you with a quote, because I like quotes. I think they're kind of special. It was a quote that I got, I heard when I graduated high school, and it goes, the best comes after the hardest climb. The best comes after the hardest climb. High school has a lot of ups and downs, lots of turns and twists. It's kind of like a roller coaster. To be able to see beyond the moment is, you know, how you develop a sense of wisdom for your approach toward life. So if you think about these challenges, you know, and what they've meant to you, you won't fall victim to these challenges. You will take them. You will end up going to, you know, across the country to a college or traveling, doing a gap year, or even staying around here and, you know, focusing on, you know, community college or working, whatever it is, whatever choice you want to make, like you are in control of that. And I hope that after this hard climb of 4 years, that you look back on it fondly as I do and appreciate all the hard work that you've done. And I want you to know how proud I personally am of all of you, and that I just can't wait for the moment where I can give you guys hugs and say really face-to-face congratulations. I knew you could do it, and I will see you soon. Bye, guys.
Hello, class of 2020. Congratulations on your graduation. I am so proud of you, and I'm so happy to be celebrating with you virtually today this awesome accomplishment. And I am here to call out a special achievement, and that is to recognize those students who completed the Innovation Diploma project this year. Several students worked hard, many of whom worked for over a year on a project related to the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals. Lots of research, lots of ethnographic work, lots of prototyping and testing and iterating and pitching and communicating their project. And over the course of the last year or more, have completed a project that met all the requirements for the Innovation Diploma Certificate. And I think it's worth noting that this year it might have been even more difficult to complete this project than it ever has been. And that's because of the conditions of sheltering in place. And we had teams who were prototyping digitally, who did hard pivots to test their products in ways that they hadn't ever intended to, and who were pitching their ideas and defending their work and their learning over Zoom. And so I commend you all for your persistence and your hard work and your commitment to these projects. You really are embodying the DTEC mission already by making the world a better place. Congratulations.
Hey, class of 2020, given all that you have gone through to get to this moment, I just couldn't let you leave without saying a personal goodbye. You started as young, eager ninth graders in an empty auto body shop with 400 students crammed into small classrooms with makeshift walls. It was noisy. You sat on the floor in the hangar for community meetings. You earned the privilege of getting In-N-Out Burger for lunch. You were empathy warriors and clean machines, and you loved it. You are the last graduated class of Design Tech High School to have spent a full year in our Rollins Road home. And then came the Oracle move. You not only survived the transition to 275 Oracle Parkway, you thrived. You quickly took over the DRG. You brought TEDx to life. You participated in Oracle Open World. You made your mark on everything from the robotics team to the yearbook. In your junior year, you rolled with it when we adopted CBL, and you bravely faced a global pandemic while finishing your senior year in high school. You are unstoppable. You are innovators, you are creators. You are mentors, your kindness and empathy knows no bounds. You have no idea the legacy you are leaving behind. You all, the class of 2020, are DTEC. Whether you are at Rollins Road, or here, or in your future home, you are what makes DTEC special. You may physically move on, but you have left a legacy far greater than you know. You will always be in our memories and in our hearts. You are brave, you are curious, you are innovative, you are tenacious. You are the class of 2020.
Thank you, Kathleen, and all of our speakers. That last commercial interruption was brought to you by Buzz Learning and Hangar Wi-Fi. Yes, we believe that your connection timed out while you were submitting your performance task. But seriously, thank you for sticking with us and all these technical difficulties. And to me, this what is happening is just embodies how amazing you are. So while we have been scrambling around here, rolling up our sleeves, trying to figure this out, we have gotten emails and text messages from DTEC community members wanting to drive down here and help us fix the problem. And that's what you're going to remember from this graduation. I don't know if you saw it at the beginning, but our goal for you is that during this time, you have a sense of love, a sense of joy, a sense of optimism. And just like you have done for the past 4 years, class of 2020, seeing those student speakers, you're the ones that are going to make this graduation awesome. It is your creativity and your awesomeness that's going to make this the memorable event. So as we go forward, I just want to thank you, class of 20, for making DTEC such a special place. And you've done that because you've always stayed true to who you are. You've shared your creativity and yourselves with one another. You are a collection of individuals that have come together as a class of 2020, and that is on full display. So we're now going to have your advisors introduce each of you as you share a piece of who you are with the world. And this time is going to work. So Paul, Sarah, take it away. Tell you where.
Hey, everyone. So as you can see, I'm out here on the Sea of Thieves practicing social distancing. But since I don't see any other pirates on the horizon right now, I climbed up here to the crow's nest so we can have a little chat. And I wish I could say all of this to you in person. But today, what I want to start by doing is to thank each and every one of you for giving me the opportunity to become your advisor. You guys kindly put up with all of my many shortcomings. And when I didn't know the answer to something, which was often, one or more of you would often speak up and provide the info to the group. I know this advisory group has had a rather winding road to follow. Maybe that explains why you were always there for each other and for me as well. But being your advisor has been an honor, a privilege, and it's something I know I'll remember for the rest of my life. So thank you again, guys. Now, that said, I need to give some shout outs. I got to start with Avia Levitt. I was good friends with Terry Hu, and when Terry left unexpectedly last spring, I came into her classroom just to see how you guys were doing. And it was Avia who asked me a simple question. Hey, Paul, can you just be our advisor? If Avia hadn't asked, I wouldn't be speaking to you guys today. It's that simple. And it's a great lesson, too. If you want something in life, you should speak up and you should go for it. And since then, we've all had some great moments, both individually and as a group. So I can't thank Michaela Thompson and Cami Kurtzman enough for organizing our pancake breakfast back in February. Who knew that would be one of the last times we'd be together in the same room on campus. Big shout out to Emily Soy and Nico Higashi for decorating our breakout room in style over the holidays. Happy holidays. I was chaperoning the holiday dance, and in walk Edward, Kevin, Christian, and Evan, looking smooth and trying to take over the DJ booth so they can play Kazi's latest track. And I'm like, yep, those are my guys. I remember finding out interesting things about some of you guys, like Sean Duarte having created and taught a curriculum for senior citizens in his community, or realizing that Aiden Cody wasn't just a good writer, but also a good photographer. I'd probably never have known those things if not for being your advisor. Sometimes it was just fun hanging out with you guys. Annabelle Gutman and Alexis Wang were always showing me photos of neighborhood cats. It seemed like Luis Obregon was always sharing his breakfast with me. Cooper Bliss and Anthony Toriano made me laugh from start to finish. Cooper literally from day one when he gave me a fake name. Sam Lash and I talked about writing, and we shared some of our works with each other and gave each other feedback. And a lot of us bonded over computer games, including Sam, who was one of the first to sail with me in Sea of Thieves. Another fearless crewmate in Sea of Thieves was Jaron Benson. And I'll never forget the night of Matt Morley's 18th birthday when I got to join him, Jocelyn McHugo, Claire Little, and some of the robotics team playing online games. I'm not going to lie, it felt cool to be included, and it was a lot of fun. And on the subject of inclusion, let me give a shout out to Sean Moyer and Felix Gutierrez. Guys, I know you could have picked any advisory for graduation purposes, but you chose ours. I've known both of you guys for over 3 years now. It's nice to close this out together. So, with all of that said, there is only one thing left to say, and it is the most important thing of all. Big congratulations to all of our DTEC graduates. You guys, the class of 2020. Evan Arriaga.
I would just like to wish everyone luck as we all set out on a new chapter of our lives. I also hope everyone stays true to themselves and achieves their goals. Thank you.
Jaron Parker Benson.
Hi, my name's Jaron Benson, and during my 3 years at Design Tech High School, I got to lead the robotics team, invent new technology, and design the newspaper. But in the end, the only thing that will have mattered is the friends I made along the way. Thank you for flying with me on Design Tech Airlines.
Cooper Bliss.
No. Baby.
Aiden Cody. Edward Daniel.
Hi, my name is Edward Daniel, and I just want to say I'm really thankful to all the DTEC staff and faculty who helped me out over the past 4 years, and a big thank you to all my lifelong friends that I made at DTEC. And on top of that, I would like to thank my wonderful parents who worked so hard to help me throughout all of high school and found DTEC for me. So thank you guys so much. I really appreciate it.
Sean Duarte.
Hi everyone, Sean here. We've had a great 4 years together, and it sucks that we weren't able to finish as a group. At the very least, we can take some solace in the fact that we didn't finish here.
Felix Gutierrez.
Like your average DTEC student, they jump and leap out of bed to go to a DTEC advisory, but instead of taking a car, they go to the Zoom call meeting.
Next, the daily ritual.
But of course, never forgetting to study. Congrats, class of 2020. You persevered and adapted through everything. You can make it anywhere. Good luck.
Annabelle Gutman.
It's been real, guys!
Nico Higashi. Alexis Wang.
I'm Alexis Huang from Asian Street Food Delights. And how to become a teenage cat lady.
And I'm Claire McDonald from Boba Food Network, CM Danceworks, and World's Cutest Pets. And you're watching the Design Tech High School Virtual Graduation Ceremony.
Cameron Kurtzman. Sam Lash.
Thank you to all my advisors, all my teachers, everyone who's ever said hi to me in the hallways. It's been great knowing you guys, and it will be interesting to see what we all do in the future. I'm Sam Lash, and I'm out.
Avia Levitt.
Thank you for everything that I've learned at DTEC. I appreciate my experience at this school. I'm really glad that I chose to go there. I had a lot of experiences and I met a lot of people. And honestly, I don't have any regrets because there's just a lot of stuff that I learned. Thank you for everything that everybody has taught me there and for all the people that I've encountered. And all the experiences I've had there, good and bad. Life goes on and I know we're all gonna go on to do bigger and better things. And not better than DTEC. DTEC's awesome, but I mean, we're gonna go on to do awesome things that are just as good as DTEC. And I hope we all come back and visit, and I wish good luck to all of us in the world.
Yeah. Claire Little.
Hi, this is Claire Little. DTEC isn't special because of the building or the policies or the underlying ideologies. It's special because of the people who are interesting in the best definition of the word. Stay weird, DTEC.
Kevin Lynch.
All right, here comes the 1-1 pitch. Strike, perfect down the middle. All right, the next pitch. Slam, it's going deep. Where is it? And it's caught! Amazing catch by Kevin Lynch.
Jocelyn McHugo. Matthew Morley.
Hey, it's Matt. Send it. It worked the first time.
Sean Moyer.
Hi, DTEC. Sean here. I'm psyched to graduate, and I want to give a huge thank you to all my classmates, my teachers, and to Melissa, my advisor.
Luis Obregón.
Gracias a Dios, a mi mamá, a mi hermano y a mi papá Julio por haberme apoyado todo este tiempo. Gracias a ellos ya lo hice hasta aquí, estos 4 años. Y también gracias a ellos por enseñarme that tomorrow is always going to be a new day.
Christian Santana.
Hi, Christian Santana here. Thank you, peers and teachers, for an amazing 4 years at Design Tech High School. Christian out.
Emily Crizel Soy.
Hi, it's Emily Soy from Design Tech High School, and I want to say that I'm really happy to have met everyone here, and I'm really grateful for the opportunity to come to DTEC, and I hope to see you guys at the end of all this. Confetti.
Michaela Thompson.
I'm so glad I got to spend the last 4 years with you all. I wish you nothing but the best for whatever comes next in your lives. We finally made it to graduation class of 2020.
Anthony Toriano.
I'm Anthony Toriano, and this is Mitzi. Congrats, DTEC class of 2020.
Today I don't feel like doing anything. I just wanna lay in my bed.
What's up, Last Air Fenners? This is Mr. Fenner coming at you from 15 feet up in a tree because we gotta have some fun with this. Okay? This has been a wild ride. Many of us started together when you were freshmen. And at that time, there were some different hairdos. And the hangar was really big. And open session was full of lots of topics. There was a lot of, what am I going to do in this situation? You might remember. When sophomore year rolled around, some of you joined us. And some of you moved on. Or some of you out there moved on out of our group. You guys are out there. You're honorary air fenders if you want to be. No pressure, right? But in the whole process, we also moved to the Oracle building. You guys were developing as individuals. And in the process, there was some conflict that came out, right? Conflict and more of that indecision. What do I do? And open session was a place where we worked through that a lot. I know that some of you definitely found open session to be a bit of a safe haven and a useful space. And some of you may have thought that it was a questionable use of time. And if that was you, I really appreciate that you stuck with it for the benefit of others. Okay. In junior year, we did lose a couple other people as well to other pastors. So we lost them in face, but not in memory, of course. But we also were in the new building. We had to figure out how to manage the fact that the table arrangements made it really hard to have a circle of chairs. And so our method of processing kind of shifted a bit. In senior year, we went on the ropes course field trip in San Francisco, and some of you made that fully functional smoke breathing dragon head out of a lava lamp box, and it was amazing. And one of you, I quote, said, "Wow, I think this is one of the first times we've actually worked together in something." So that was cool. I just wanted to make note of that. So senior fall was also your introduction to CBL. And we can all remember how those open sessions went, right? But you made it through, and here you are. So if there's one common thread weaving its way through all of this, I think it's this idea of shared conflict, indecision, and general sense of what do I do, okay? What do I do when I don't like something the way it is? What do I do when I want to do something but I'm not sure if I should, right? Just indecision, conflict. And some of you are going on to the next phases of your life with more of that, and some of you feel more confident. But regardless of where you're at with that, I have a story that I've assembled, a sort of like a metaphorical story that I'm piecing together from things I've heard, from wisdom that I've taken to heart. And I'm gonna leave you with this in case it's useful for any of you, in case you think back to it later, maybe tonight, maybe in 20 years, who knows. But with that, I'm going to miss you guys, and I look forward to the next time we get to see each other and hear how things are going. Okay, see ya. Imagine you are standing in front of a wave at the ocean. You have two basic options for which way to face. You can face away from the wave, or you can face the wave directly. Either wave, the wave is coming at you. If you face the wave as it comes at you, it might make you nervous, scared, or even terrified if you don't know how to engage the wave. Once you learn how to engage the wave, though, you realize that you can go over the wave if you move toward it before it crashes on you, or you can go underneath the wave as it crashes and the water passes over you. Either way, having studied the wave, and by applying understanding and skill that you developed over time, you maintain control in the situation and end up facing the same direction with the wave behind you. Now imagine facing away from the wave. You have no idea when the wave will crash on you or how big it will be. So even if you do have understanding and skill related to waves, you are not really in control. Not fully aware of what is right behind you, you cannot be fully prepared to respond when it crashes over you. This might be even more unsettling, startling, or frightening than before, and may possibly knock you off your feet. So, last airfanners, and the entire class of 2020, as you enter the next chapter of your lives, and as you find yourselves presented with conflict or indecision of any kind,
Imagine that you are in front of a wave. Do you want to maintain as much control in the situation as possible, with the conflict eventually ending up behind you? Or do you want to risk being unpredictably knocked down, still facing the conflict? If you prefer the former, I encourage you to embrace your fears and uncertainties. Study and notice the details in the situation before you, and find your way to engage the wave. I might mess around and get my college degree. I bet my old man will be so proud of me. But sorry, Pops, you'll just have to wait.
Phoebe Baggett.
I'm Phoebe Baggett, and I've had a wonderful time here at DTEC these last 4 years. I would like to congratulate all of my peers and friends who are graduating as well, and give a big thank you to all the teachers who have got me here and got my classmates here. We appreciate you so much.
Sophia Daskalakis.
Sophia Daskalakis.
Chloe Dong.
Thank you, DTEC, for the past 4 years of craziness and excitement. I had so much fun at Rollins and at the new campus. I hope to everyone that they have a great and amazing new chapter in their lives.
Zale Dreyer Fadiman.
I'm Zale Fadiman, and I just graduated from DTEC.
Connor William Fagans.
I come from a place where classrooms have no walls. From mystical dragons and countless waterfalls to Panera with friends. From cut ribbons in corporate cafes to clubs and college essays, and finally, back home. From the past to the bright future ahead, thank you, DTEC.
Alana Forster.
Hi, my name is Alana Forster, and I'm in the DTEC class of 2020. I just wanted to thank all my fellow students. DTEC has been such a wonderful place the 3 years that I've been here, and that's really due to the community. And I just wanted to thank the teachers and my fellow students who've made DTEC as accepting and wonderful a place community as it is. Thank you so much.
Benjamin Gao.
Ben Gao.
Sonova Kafitz Vung. Brandon Liu.
Peace out, DTEC.
Sonal Maharaj. Boris Ariel Malikin. Ian Patrick O'Hare.
Guys, I didn't start at DTEC, but over the last 3 years, it's begun to feel like home. I'll be sad to see everybody go, but special shout out to Mr. Fenner and Ms. Sigmund for always being there for me, always having my back and pushing me to do better. Thank you.
Nicole Walker. Owen Keith Walsh.
My name's Owen and I'm pretty cool. I just got out of Design Tech High School. I reach new heights and I don't need a ladder. Gonna make every moment of my life matter. It's me, Owen, and I've got the flow. Every day, every night, just watch me go. See you later, DTEC. I'm off to college. Thanks for the years of support and knowledge.
Luke Watson.
Hey,
just move on up toward your destination. Though you may find from time to time complication.
As a teacher, I've always tried to develop close relationships with my students, but nothing could have prepared me for the closeness I feel for this group.
We are like a family.
We console each other through our setbacks.
We look out for each other.
Sometimes we fight.
Sometimes we may not even like each other.
But we always care for one another.
Sometimes we wrap Stevie in a parachute.
And drag his body around the school.
It never hurt though. Well, not that much anyway.
We play together.
We work together.
We laugh together.
We cry together.
But it's more than just that.
We are together.
Over these 4 years,
we have become...
And we are...
Family.
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 Family. Family.
I want to thank all the parents for letting me share in the lives of your sons and daughters. We bonded almost immediately, and our relationship has grown stronger as we explored the world of DTEC together. Now they embark on the next stage of their life journey. I'm sad to see them go, and I'm excited to see where they will go. I proudly present these students as part of the graduating class of Design Tech High School for 2020. Nathan Ao Young.
Nathan Ao Young.
Carson Carini.
Hello there, and congratulations to us, the class of 2020. Over the past 1,381 days that we've spent together, we've done it! We bore fruits to our labor, all of our hard work, and it's finally paying off. And as a toast, I would like to congratulate us and our futures. Go Dragons.
Jacob Kai Cohen.
Hi, Jacob Cohen here. I'm taking a break from my Zoom classes and wandering the halls of our abandoned school to let you know that despite the goose poop on the ground and the confetti plastered to the wall, the school really is incomplete without us. I miss you all and can't wait to be with you soon.
Cato Frank. Julia Green.
Bird watching goes both ways.
Ethan Kravitz. Brendan Chang-Wei Lin.
Hey guys, it's me, Brendan Lin, and thank you guys for the last 4 years. It's been such a great experience. The roller coaster, moving campuses and going around and whatnot. But now that we've graduated and now we have to all talk to each other virtually, I hope to see you everyone in Minecraft. See you later.
Daniel Yong Tok Pong.
a friend in me. You've got a friend in me. When the road looks rough ahead and you're miles and miles from your nice warm bed, you just remember what your old pal said. Boy, you got a friend in me.
Christian Phillips.
My name is Christian Phillips. I am graduating today. I really wish this wasn't online, though.
Graduation, all my dreams, rock and trade his royal plate. With this mail!
Phoebe Clara Rack.
Oh my gosh, I'm so surprised. I was not expecting this at all. I'd like to thank all my teachers, my advisor, Mr. Grote, Melissa, and all the administration for helping me get here. I also want to thank my parents, my sisters, all my extended family for always being there for me, and of course, my friends and DTEC classmates. As everyone keeps telling us, we bonded forever because of this experience. I'm so lucky I've gotten to go to DTEC, and I'm so grateful for everything it's done for me. Thank you so much.
Kylie Rosario.
Hey guys, it's kind of hard to put my life in 20 seconds, but let's give it a try. I love martial arts, softball, and doing my nails. But most of all, I love my two crazy best friends.
I got the wrong way!
And to my class.
Thank you, class of 2020, for making my 4 years of high school a little bit less miserable. I'll see you guys soon.
Kale Shaw.
Thank you, DTEC. Ethan Harris, Carl Shedd. Reeve Silver. Mia Alexandria Tapia. Stevie Daniel Varghese.
Oh, didn't see you there. Well, I want to give a big shout out to all the people that made these last 4 years some of the best of my life. And I bid you all farewell. Big Steve out.
Jemani Wilson. Isabel Yu.
Class of 2020, good evening. Happy graduation, and specifically my advisory. It's a glorious occasion. We've made it. 4 years together. You know, we both came in to DTEC at the same time. My first year teacher back at Rollins, your first year as a freshman. We met in economics, and then we met in that corner next to the fishbowl. That was Chelsea Little's room, eventually Terry Hughes' room. And we would circle up those blue chairs. They were a little crusty, a little dirty, but we circled up and we began some check-ins and we got to know each other and how we're feeling. We learned a little bit about each other and then we elevated to open session. And from there, I think we really began to connect as a small community within the school. And I just want to really thank you for that because I learned a lot about you and your families, your goals, aspirations, and who you are and what you want to be. And so I don't got a lot of wisdom or knowledge to drop right now. But I do want to say a couple of things. And first, as you move forward in this new beginning, this new cycle, this new journey, it's not an ending, it's a new beginning. You're just going to explore and learn and see a lot of things that you did not know existed. And you're going to become a better version of yourself. And I think that's what's so exciting, is that you are going to really focus in on your skills and your desires and your talents and use that to make the world a better place, which we've been preaching for years, right? So I don't have a lot of things to say like I've mentioned, but I would like you to think about anything worthwhile, anything quality takes time, takes effort, takes failure, takes leaning in, takes asking questions, takes practicing empathy. So do those things, because if you do, you will create solid relationships, you will create solid products, and you will be a happier human. And I think in the end, you know, our goal is to make people feel good. You know, the great Maya Angelou said, people won't remember what you know, they won't remember what you say, but they'll remember how you make them feel. So as you move forward and transition into your next journey, make people feel good. And this isn't the end, it's a new beginning, so stay in touch. I'm gonna miss you, and take care. Congratulations.
Fyodor Banchev. Leo Bellman.
I've always wondered if the car sticking out of the auto body shop on Rollins Road is there because of a design choice or an unfortunate accident. And I think that's the theme of DTEC as a whole. Very quirky and a little concerning. Over the years, I've had a lot of great teachers at DTEC. Mr. Lahneman, Fanny, Mr. Pierce, Ms. Anderson, Mr. Wilgus, and many more. I'll remember all of them, and I'll remember all of you guys. Thank you very much.
Leon Bensadon. Carter Bowie.
Carter Bowie.
Adam Sepulkowskis. Adeline Chen.
Hi, I'm Adeline Chen.
Noah Chen. Corwin Davidson.
I, Corwin Davidson, would like to thank the art of procrastination, which is the thing that is presently causing me to film this as the sun is about to go down, desperately jeopardizing my graduation prospects of actually having a video that doesn't suck. However, the thing that I would most like to think about all of DTEC beyond time limits is...
Lydon Fuller. Avery Grayval.
Hi, my name is Avery Grable. I'm graduating from Design Tech High School in the class of 2020. I'm planning to attend CU Boulder in the class of 2024 for Engineering Plus. I'm hoping to be a product designer in the future. Let's go Buffs!
Kate Hayashigatani.
Hey guys, it's Kate, and I just wanted to congratulate the class of 2020 on graduating and for all the hard work. I learned so much from you guys, and I can't wait to see what everyone does in the future and all that you accomplish.
Jack Maiden. Claire McDonald.
Hi, I'm Alexis Huang from Asian Street Food Delights. And how to become a teenage cat lady.
And I'm Claire McDonald from Boba Food Network, CM Danceworks, and World's Cutest Pets. And you're watching the Design Tech High School Virtual Graduation Ceremony.
Yamini Prasad. Hunter Sayed.
I say a quick thank you to the DTech staff and all my friends I made over the years for supporting me and making me who I am today. I will forever be grateful for all of you. Thank you.
Laura Thornley. Jane Wang.
Hi, I'm Jane.
My dear students, I chose my parents' backyard, which is full of feral cats around, but it has some nice shade. And it shows that spring is here and that new beginnings are coming forward for you guys. I wanted to be surrounded by the garden, by nature. You know how big I am with that and how important it is for you to keep the torch. So it's time to say goodbye. And I've been thinking so long on what is it that I'm going to tell you. And my problem is that I want to give all the experiences I've had to protect you so you can have so many ideas on what to do whenever you encounter a problem. But you know what? You are ready for that. We've worked hard these last 4 years for you guys to become the young adults you are now. And you really are ready for anything that comes your way. So I'm not worried about you. I think that you're going to do fine. You're going to continue being the amazing people you are. I know you will continue to be the only advisory that has no idea what a circle means. Well, you know what it means. You don't know how to make one. That's the thing. And I wish I could tell you one thing that has allowed me to be strong many times. And there is this saying in Spanish, and it's something like this. Remember that the kite flies against the wind. Whenever you find yourself against something, remember that that's exactly how the kite flies. Patchy Ackerman.
Patchy Ackerman.
Matthew Bowley. Matthew Bone.
Too deep when I rap. Ruby getting out for the pills that I supply. The screws are bound, flat ties in a 06 Chevy. Looking like I'm Bloody Mary, sipping codeine and barium.
Hiramasa Urenisi. Jack Fields. Chris Gashiwala.
Congratulations to my classmates and thank you to all my teachers for making these past 4 years fun and exciting. Thanks to my family for helping me through this journey, and I'd like to wish my classmates the best of luck in the next stages of our lives. College is here we go.
Marek Garbashonik.
That's got to be the best part I've ever seen.
So it would seem.
I am Marek Garbashonik.
Max Hoffelman. Casey Kisling. Jason Raderman.
Jason Raderman.
Oliver Simpson. Maya Tochimoto.
Thank you for 4 years.
Alyssa Wend.
Hi, I'm Alyssa Wend from the class of 2020, and you're watching Disney Channel.
Eli Wood.
Eli here. Thanks to Carolina and Sarah for helping me out all these years, and thank you to all my teachers. Yeah!
Mama called, seen you on TV. Sunset done changed ever since we was on. I dreamed it all ever since I was young. They said I won't be nothing. Now they always say congratulations. Worked so hard, forgot how to vacation.
Hi everyone. I'm just here hanging out with my advisory, and I wanted to say a big congratulations to the class of 2020, and although I so wish we could be together today, I hope you know how proud we all are of you. And to my advisory, I haven't been an advisor for long. In fact, we only had 7 weeks together before our lives became one long Zoom meeting. But it has been so fun to get to know all of you this semester, and I'm really grateful to have joined you. You all describe this advisory as chill, sleepy, and just straight lazy. And while yes, you do start your day a little slow, and you always play it cool about your accomplishments, no matter how much I pry, I've seen how you all care deeply about the people around you, how you've achieved incredible things both in and out of school, and overcome some pretty intense obstacles along the way. So in honor of the generous spirit of these students, I decided to give advisory awards voted on by their peers, and here's how they recognized each other. Julia, an artist, a plant mom with a green thumb, and the winner of the Leslie Knope Award for relentless dedication to making a difference. Kira, our leader, an optimist, a joy to be around, and the winner of the Peacemaker Award, most likely to solve global conflicts. Jackson, kind to everyone, generous, and the winner of the Bill Gates Award, most likely to give away all of his money. Olivia, a shining star, funny and enthusiastic, and winner of the Bright Lights Award, most likely to perform on Broadway. To Anthony, a thoughtful and heartfelt person who everyone loves, the Winning at Life Award, most likely to thrive after high school. To Erica, who's fiercely loyal, strong, and takes care of business, the Life Coach Award, most likely to coach everyone to success. To Spencer, who's resilient and unique with the best taste in music, the winner is of the DJ Khaled Bless Up Award, most likely to provide sweet jams and good vibes. Lily always speaks her mind, has boundless energy, and was voted as the future senator, most likely to have her name on a ballot someday. Aya is optimistic, funny, and incredibly dedicated, and the winner of the Advocate Award, most likely to stand up for a worthy cause. Jake is a friend you can count on. He'll help with anyone out of a rut and is the winner of the Limited Edition Award for being the most stylish and business savvy. Timmy is kind, hardworking, and adventurous, and the winner of the Explorer Award, most likely to sail around the world and come back with the best stories. Aiden stands up for what he believes in, supports his friends, and has a remarkable amount of random knowledge. The Alex Trebek Award, most likely to dominate all of us at trivia. Diego is all around the nicest human, both talented and humble, and the winner of the Outstanding Talent Award, most likely to EGOT. Kyle entertains us with stories, takes great care when it comes to his fish and coral, and is the winner of the Ethical Hacker Award, most likely to use his technical skills for good. Mia is determined, funny, an amazing water gun assassin, and wins the Strength Under Pressure Award, most likely to overcome any obstacle that comes her way. Kelly is a talented photographer and equestrian with a big heart. To Kelly, the Animal Whisperer Award, most likely to take in all of the animals. Leon brings joy to the group and is known for the fact that he can and will sleep anywhere. The Max Relax Award goes to Leon for blurring the line between relaxed and just plain asleep. Shane is a calm, steady presence in the group and is truly his own person. To Shane, the Ron Swanson Award for being a lovable outdoorsman and most likely to live off the grid. Jacob is a quiet observer with a brilliant mind who we all know will go far. He was voted as most likely to quietly take over the world. And last but not least, Clayton is the friend that everyone deserves. He radiates kindness and is the winner of the Ultimate Empathy Warrior Award. Congratulations to all of you. I can't wait to see what you do next. Say congratulations. Congratulations. So hard, forgot how to vacation. They ain't never had the dedication. People hating, say we changing, look, we made it. Lily Bloom. Diego Tristan Coeli.
I'm Diego Coeli.
Aiden Denton.
I'd like to say thank you to my family and friends for helping me through high school, and I'd also like to give a special thanks to DTEC for giving me so many opportunities I wouldn't have been able to have if I'd gone somewhere else. So, yeah.
Shane DeVolder. Jackson Drews.
What's up, class of 2020? I just want to give a special thanks to Mr. Grote and Sarah Lou Casey for making me not want to die in math, and I want
want to thank Veggie Chang for punching a hole in the wall in the bathroom every single time. It was really funny.
Kyle Fuji.
Thanks to all my teachers, all my friends, all the cool new people I've met. I love you all. And I just want to say, oh wait, hold on one second. Get out of the road, buddy! Get the f*** out of the road!
Timmy G.
Hi guys, it's Timmy G. Out here sailing. Boat life. I want to thank D10 for 4 great years. It was a lot of fun. And I can't believe it has to end this way. But thank you. And good luck to everybody in the class of 2020. Good luck to all my friends. Oh!
Anthony Guardado.
Anthony Guardado.
Olivia Lucille Gutierrez. As we go on, we remember all the times we spent together. As our lives change from whatever. Kelly Hill. Erica Hillhouse.
Erica Hillhouse.
Kira Hoffelman. Spencer Kishiyama.
Vlog part one. This is the graduation vlog. My name is Spencer Kishiyama. My OOTD. What? Vlog part two. On my way to graduation. Alright, that's it for the vlog. Shout out class of 2020.
Leon Kwok.
7 out of 10. Would do again.
Julia Lederman.
Someone's coming. Are you kidding me? Did it! Woo!
Clayton Lair.
I just want to say thank you for all the time I spent at DTech. I couldn't have done it without my friends, my family, and my teachers, and I hope everybody has a great future.
Jacob Nebling. Jacob Nguyen. Aya O'Malley. Mia Psyche.
Bye, D-Tech.
Mr. Blue Sky, please tell us why you had to hide away for so long. Where did we go wrong?
It is with great pleasure and obviously some sadness that I greet you for the last time as your advisor. I say that also knowing our connections never need to end, and I hope that as we grow more distant, we do not grow apart. So you did it. I'm sure you're excited, but probably a bit frightened as well. I remember feeling, as a newly minted adult, extremely motivated by the unknown. But also equally intimidated by the idea that I alone was responsible for my life and how it went. I remember thinking that since I was an adult, since I was grown, I should know where I was going in my life and know what I should be doing with my time. But you know what? I definitely didn't know those answers with any certainty. And I never will, for that matter. The events of our world continually prove that uncertainty and endless possibility will always rival any and all moments of certainty. It's okay to be unsure, as long as you care. Remember, take meaningful risks. It's empowering. It gives you agency. Also, accept your failures. They are the learning we take away from our experiences. I believe that all experiences can be improved in some way. Perfect is just a bias. Iterations and improvements challenge the normalized, so we can embrace the view that the world can be better, and we can help to make it that way. I want you to know that being your advisor has been one of the high points of my career. Getting to know you all each day has given me perspective, as well as a caring, safe place to just be. It has not been without challenge, but it has been, to me, perfect. Thank you all for that. Now, moving forward, hold on to your values of resilience and empathy as you start the next leg. They will help you keep your perspective when uncertainties abound. Our thoughts serve us best when they are actionable. Worry, dread, and self-doubt don't take us places, and we've got to go. I appreciate all of you for everything you have given of yourselves. I respect and revere you all. Thank you for our time together, and I'll never forget any of you. You're all nifty.
Nick Boyko.
You've got my heart working overtime. Give up your love if you wanna keep it. If you want my heart, if you want my job, don't play with my heart. Give me all your love. If you want my heart, if you want my job, don't play with my heart. Give me all your love.
Jasper Bull.
Hey guys, it's Jasper Bull here from the DTAC graduating class of 2020. We were supposed to submit some 20-second videos for DTAC graduation, so I just wanted to film this video, sort of say my piece.
Inti Carranza.
Hi, I'm Inti Carranza, and you're watching the DTAC class of 2020 graduate.
Benjamin Daitung Chang.
It was me. I punched a hole in the bathroom wall. I did it because it was funny, and I did it every single time. Ladies, I know you love a bad boy. Hit me up at Bendertron on Instagram. Bye.
Miriam Dihumko. Talia Drew Gillette.
Hey Winged Lizards, Talia Drew here. I want to say thanks to Sully and Grout for being there with us from day one, and thanks to all the cool cats who made the last few years a joy. From Suffering Rock Band to making murals with Mike, it's been a blast.
Anna Grinberg.
Hi, my name is Anna Grinberg. Thank you to the class of 2020 for 3 amazing years. I will miss all of you very much. I hope to see you all soon.
Erez Harrell.
Erez Harrell.
Kazi Husaini.
Hi,
Hi, everybody. Thank you to the wonderful people that I've met in the past 4 years, the teachers, the students, the staff, everyone. And remember, if our freedom of speech is taken away and we be led by the dumb and the silent, then may we die like lambs to the slaughter. Davis 24!
Ibrahim Hussein.
Ibrahim Hussein!
Hi, DTEC people. Thank you for making DTEC fun. High school is good for me, I think. Thank you.
Boom, high five.
Gabe Lim.
Thanks to all my friends and teachers who have helped me make so many great memories here at DTEC. Not going to UCI because I switched colleges last second, so I got to order new merch, but just had to ask out Fanny to prom one last time, so here it is.
Prom is canceled.
Jan Olshansky.
Hey, what's up, DTEC? It's me, Jan. Too bad we had to end off our year like this, but, you know, it really sucks. Quarantine and stuff, but, you know, it's for the better good. That's about it from me. You know, best of luck on all of your journeys. Peace out.
Alexis Santi. Gemma Schroeder.
Really out here putting the tech in DTEC with our virtual graduation, guys. Congratulations, class of 2020.
Helena Shapiro.
Hi, it's Helena. Thank you, DTEC. Congratulations, class of 2020, and the founding girls softball team on our winning season. I can't wait for Boulder. See you later. Oh, it's so cold.
Griffin Trumpler.
We did it, boys.
Aaron Tung. Nathan Wilson.
Class of 2020, our first live stream graduation has been so you. Of course, there were bumps, there were technical difficulties, but you stuck through it, and every time that we saw one of your faces come on the screen, we couldn't help but smile, remember how great you are, and how much we're going to miss you. So thank you. Just think of this as a graduation gift to you, as memento of your 4 years here. Because as somebody said, you don't go to school, you are the school. And that has been so apparent in this ceremony. So class in 2020, you've inspired me. After seeing your videos, I'm reminded that this is not normal. You are not normal. But you know what? You're better than normal. So let's not pretend that normal is so perfect and like rush back to it as quickly as possible. We're gonna get through this moment in history, but let's not just get through it and return to normal, let's make it better. Not only should we wear ski goggles and fly kites, but let's take that creative spirit you all have and let's work for more love. Let's work for more joy. Let's work for more justice in the world. You are creative, fun, empathetic, and working to make the world a better place. I couldn't be more excited for you to spread your dragon wings and fly. So, on behalf of the Design Tech High School staff and the Design Tech High School Board of Directors, I am honored to confer on each of you the status of high school graduate. I would like the class of 2020 to please rise. Yes, go ahead, get up, please rise. As a symbol of you moving from one chapter of your life to the next, you may now move your tassels to the left. You are official graduates. Congratulations. DTEC friends and family, the class of 2020.
Suddenly it's like women and men. Will the past be a shadow?